This was our RC2014 Retro Z80 computer at the end of the last video, mounted in a MakerBeam frame. The Z80 processor in the setup runs at 7.3 MHz, and the memory board has some 512K of memory, accessed by paging in 32K chunks. While this is very modest by modern standards, if you could time travel back to the early 80s, you would lead the field. This configuration also contains a VGA graphics card, which also allows a USB keyboard to be connected. What we're going to look at today is to add storage to the system. This is the compact flash module, which can be used to add 128 MB of storage. There are very few components to add to the circuit board. However, you can purchase the card part assembled with the compact flash socket already fixed in place. The pitch of the pins on this socket is very fine, and with a steady hand and preferably some magnification, you can solder these in place with the right equipment. However, paying a little extra will get you this fiddly piece of work already completed for you. With only 5 resistors, 1 capacitor, 1 LED, 1 chip socket, and the edge connector to solder, this is one of the simpler kits to assemble. Here we have the compact flash card with a 64 MB media card setup with CPM. Although you can use compact flash cards larger than 128 MB, you can only have a maximum accessible of 128 MB. A 64 MB card is split into 7 8 MB drives and 1 5 MB drive, available as drives A through to drive H. A 128 MB card is split into 15 8 MB drives and 1 2 MB drive, available as drive A to drive P. While the size of these drives may seem tiny by modern standards, they are more than adequate for a Z80 system. Time for me to go and finish assembling that card now. In the next video, we will have a look at this system running. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.